Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing a video that I've not done in a little while. I do What I Eat in Days quite often because I know they're helpful. But one thing I have not done in a while is a What I Eat in a Week. So of course, because of that, I had to do one. So I have on my laptop, you know, clips from the whole past week of food, and I'm just going to go through, watch them, narrate them through, obviously as I'm showing the clip, so you know what I'm talking about. And yeah, I'll just be explaining everything that I ate this week. So yeah, nothing too crazy, not too much to explain. That's kind of the whole intro, and let's just get into the video. So Sunday, I started out with a smoothie bowl, nothing too special. Then I had a Chipotle burrito for lunch. I ate the entire burrito, like the entire burrito, and was so stuffed afterwards, but it was really good. I came home, made some pasta. I found this gluten-free rotini in my pantry. Still don't know how I got there, but I peeled some garlic and I forget the name of this thing. Put it in this garlic press thing. I love garlic. So there was a lot of garlic, of course. How could there not be? But then I threw in some onions, it's chopped up some tomatoes, and then also chopped up some of these jarred, they're like have olive oil and some spices on, artichoke hearts. And I put those in the pan along with the onion and garlic, and then I put a bunch of seasonings on it. That's the thing about this video. I don't really recall exactly what I put on each thing, because I always just put on whatever sounds good. But I ended up adding in some spinach, the pasta. I bet I added garlic salt, pepper, Italian seasoning, I don't know, some herbs, but then I added in some Miyoko's vegan butter to help create more of a sauce. I ended up adding more butter than what I showed. But yeah, that was dinner. That was super, super good. And moving on to Monday, I started my day with an English muffin. One side had jam, one side had butter, then a poke bowl for lunch. Of course, I had tofu instead of fish, seaweed salad, avocado, cucumber, this seasoning from Trader Joe's. When you see it on the screen, that's how you pronounce it. And then I added in some sprouts and ate it with seaweed, like nori sheets. Then my dad made flautas for dinner, which he would make all the time before he was vegan, but he's never made them vegan. They were using Follow Your Heart cheese and Gardein chicken tenders. Amazing, phenomenal, so good. This was a great meal. Then Tuesday, for breakfast, I made a smoothie bowl. This one was very simple with just some frozen bananas, frozen cauliflower, almond milk, then raspberries, vanilla protein, and I ended up blending this, but I didn't like it completely, so I ended up adding in some extra frozen bananas and then some frozen cherries. Basically, I just wanted it thicker, so I added those in, blended it some more, and then I put it into a coconut bowl. This one was very, very thick, and I topped it off with some strawberries, a banana, and tahini. Might sound weird to people, tahini goes on everything in my opinion. But then for lunch, I ended up having an acai bowl. Not planned, but yes. And then for dinner, I went to this place called Sugar Taco on Melrose. If you live in the area, you should go check it out. It's like really, really, really good. I had some fish tacos and then a chicken cheese quesadilla. I'd also like to say that not one, but two people came over while we were eating this and tried it, not knowing it was vegan, and ended up really liking it. They had no idea it was vegan too, so yeah. I think we're on Wednesday now. On Wednesday, I started out with this cereal. It was this puffed rice cereal from Trader Joe's. I added in some banana, some peanut butter, and then almond milk. And I never eat cereal for breakfast. I don't really know why I made me want it this day, but I did, so I ate that. It's really good. For lunch, I chopped up a russet potato, added on some oil, definitely some salt and pepper, and then some of the alpha chicken nuggets, baked those, ate it with some bitchin sauce, some Polynesian Chick-fil-A sauce, ketchup. That was that. That was really good. For snack, I had an apple, and then lunch, I had this I used leftovers to make this avocado tofu roll thing. I ended up eating two of those. Then for dinner, I made some more fun pasta. Started out with some mushrooms, onions, garlic, vegan butter. Sauteed those up. No mushrooms yet. Don't know why I said mushrooms. Ignore that. And then once those were cooking, then I added the mushroom. Mushrooms come next. And cooked that down. I ended up adding some dairy-free milk and tapioca starch to try to make like a thicker, creamy sauce. A bunch of spices. I'm only showing nutritional yeast, a ton more. I don't really have them all filmed though. cooked that all down, added in some Morningstar vegan chicken strips, and then added it to the pasta. It was red lentil Trader Joe's pasta, if I'm right. And yeah, that was really good. I bet I topped it with more nutritional yeast because I top everything with more nutritional yeast. And yeah, that was that meal. Then on Thursday for breakfast, I had this yogurt parfait bowl with these leftover Earth Cafe nori sheet things. I chopped up a mango. Then I just put the leftovers on a plate with some of this protein yogurt added on, some other berries. I know I had strawberries, blackberries, and blueberries, I believe, along with the mango, and made a little parfait and then ate the leftovers on the side. Then for lunch, I made this really big Mediterranean-inspired platter. I started out with Brussels sprouts, onions, not zucchini, some type of squash, and then I put some oil on them with a bunch of spices again. Very vague, I apologize. But I ended up adding in some garlic and roasted those in the oven along with some tofu that I put the Trader Joe's mushroom seasoning on. Indian style flatbread from Trader Joe's is amazing, and then some of the artichoke hearts, I just wanted to show you that I was eating those. I ended up making some black bean hummus. I didn't have my good blender though, so it didn't really work out that well, but black beans, some spices, roasted garlic, lemon juice, tahini. Plated it up with some olives, pickles, rice, the bread, the roasted veggies, roasted tofu, the black bean hummus, and some of this vegan tzatziki dip from Trader Joe's, which is so good. This was a great meal. I ate it. Oh, pita chips along with artichoke hearts. And then I went to Chipotle for dinner. My Chipotle order is on the screen if you would like to check it out. Same thing as the burrito, just no tortilla. Then the next day I had a smoothie bowl, not in a bowl, but it's just like a smoothie bowl, so I'm gonna call it a smoothie bowl. I didn't eat a proper lunch this day. I went out to a baseball game, so I just had a soft pretzel with 5 packets of mustard, and that's about it. So sorry, that's kind of boring, but I came home and I have some of these frozen veggie pot stickers that I got out of the freezer, and I, you know, cooked them in a pan, and I made this slurry type thing with cornstarch and a few other ingredients. I have it in a past What Eaten Day video. Also ate some of this ice cream while cooking. I made these dumplings with that, and you pour it over and you cook it, so it creates like a crispy film. That sounds gross, but it tastes good on the bottom. And I made this sauce from Snack Queen on TikTok. You have to look, I'm obsessed with her, but her videos are amazing. Anyway, she made this sauce. This video, I did not make the sauce the way that she did. I made a ton of alterations because I didn't have everything. So I recommend checking her video, and then don't use oyster sauce like she does because it's not vegan, obviously. So I don't use oyster sauce, and it turns out amazing. But yes, made that sauce. Super good. The dumplings were amazing. And then that night for dessert, I used some Earth Balance butter, the same cereal, and then some vegan marshmallows that my mom found at Smart and Final. And I made some vegan Rice Krispie Treats. I've not had homemade Rice Krispie Treats since going vegan, I don't think. So these were so good. I ate a bunch that night. Don't really have much to show, but I ate a bunch. And then the next morning I had a smoothie that I ended up filling right to the brim. Did very good with that. I ate this lunch that I didn't film, but I took a photo of. It was veggie burger sauteed with mushrooms and onions, baked potato, avocado sprouts, spring mix, bitchin' sauce, and salsa. And then I ate a few of those Rice Krispie Treats and some carrots and bitchin' sauce for a midnight snack, and that was my whole week. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Let me know if you want more. I think I've done 3, maybe 4 of these in the past, so of course that whole playlist with all the videos, if you'd like to go check those out, will be linked in the description. So thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to let me know by leaving me a thumbs up, because the more thumbs up I get in this video, like, the more I'll know that you guys want to see more of these. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next video.